Not at all.
Well, it doesn't really, because it comes out the side of your mask. As I said, if you understand, being an engineer, right? Yeah, because you know you're good in all fields.
Oh, crap.
Well, you must know about the, as I said, the, what they call it, I've forgotten now, but the, when you spray,
deodorant on yourself, you know, when it's such fine particles, well, that's what's coming out in your breath.
Yeah, we know all that.
Well,
we
then if you're planning on stopping it, then if you're in a room, is it?
This attenuates it. In other words, it redirects it.
Yeah.
Certainly, if it comes out, it's going to come out, and if it's not trapped, it will seep out anyhow. But if you've been in front of a bloody dog that's got gut trouble, and he comes and licks your face, that's bloody horrible. Well, if you've got a mask on, you can't smell it.
I'll tell you what, you lot just carry on being guinea pigs, that's all I've got to say, but don't get at me for not being wanting to be one, all right?
I'm not getting at you, Tony.
Look, Tony, I don't like disagreeing with you, right?
We know even the best of masks is for donkey shoes. I once woke up and there were four on the bloody operating table, all bloody masks on. There will be some that apply, but it's a degree of protection. If it's only preventing 5 or even 10% of the particles from getting out, it's a degree of protection. I'll agree with you. Without this book, and lots of books in that tidy, there's some going to escape. But the less of the books that get out, the less chance, because, you know, it's all a matter of odds, same as anything else.
Well, perhaps we've got to put it a simple way. Well, you've seen the skid marks on your underpants, Tony. Just imagine if you hadn't got them on.
I don't have anything like that. I've never had anything like that. I always have a great degree of personal hygiene.
What do you think people that are spraying put a mask on for? So they can get more of the paint up their nose? No, it stops it to some extent.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we're not talking about paint now, Eric. We're talking about a virus, right? And you have medical grade masks, you know, which the surgeon wears, medical grade, which is... I would say at least some, even that's not 100% sure on that one, but it certainly is a lot better than them masks you can buy that don't even give you barely, I don't know, about 8 microns, and you've got a 1 micron thing that coming out, breathing in or out would make no bloody difference.
It's like Tony Preston said, Tony. If it only stops a quarter of it, it's better than the whole thing going in, isn't it? Surely to God.
Well, that's not the way you quarantine, though, Fred, is it? If you're going to stop it, you've got to either wear the proper mask so you're not spreading it at all.
You can't, well...
It's not a quarantine. Having a mask is not a quarantine. It's not a complete stopper. Everybody knows that. It just reduces it.
Well, I don't buy into that it does, you know, not by the aerosol effect. You know we've been spraying aerosol. How far and wide that spreads. It's the same when you breathe. Even if it's, say, 10% less, you're still spreading it around you, so I don't see what's your point.
Well, I'll put it to that. Right, try this little experiment. Get your deodorant to whatever you've got, an aerosol, and stand in front of a mirror, and then spray the deodorant to whatever on a mirror, right? And then get a piece of anything, a piece of gauze, it doesn't need to be all that, and put it over the top of your aerosol can, and then spray that at the mirror, and you'll see the difference.
Well, I think you'll find that the spray coming out of an aerosol can will be a slightly different aerosol effect coming out from your breath, Tony, but either way... Any that's escaping is no good, because if it escapes and anyone's near you, they can get it, can't they? Come on. Anyway, you look,
You lot of rats, you keep believing what you want to believe. Now, once the experiment's over, I'll make a decision then. But I'm not like you lot. I don't just follow down the road because someone says so.
Well, if they make one of those bubbles, which they use Survivor, you can have one of those.
Well, I said my piece and that's it. You know, you keep believing what you want to believe.
What is the degree of protection? We're not saying 100%, of course we're not, but it's a degree of protection, and I think that's better to have it than being cuffed on by some bloke that's got a terrible bloody bug next door to you.
You've all had the bloody jabs. I don't know what the hell are you even frightened about. You know, you're all kind of like little schoolgirls.
The jab doesn't stop it.
Well, it stops you dying, apparently, and that's the most important thing, isn't it?
No, it doesn't stop it. There's no guarantee that it stops it. I've got a radio amateur friend that's had both the jabs and he's still got COVID. But you're less likely to die if you've had the vaccination than if you haven't.
Well, no, that statement you made doesn't hold at all. You know, he's had the jab, but he's still getting it, so... You know, he has to die with it,
it's a waste of time, this person.
Yeah, well, it is, because I'm not going to go along with you sheep. You sheep and little lab rats, you keep going away the way you're going and leave me the hell alone, that's all right.
Well,
everybody's got their point of view, Tony, but why are you so down on it?
Yeah, I mean... There can't be many. Everybody doesn't agree with it. We know that. But there's lots of things that you couldn't do, and you unless you go to it by the rules. And there's not so many of you that don't believe in it as what there is of us.
Oh, there's a lot of your world leaders that don't believe in it. I mean, you've only got to look at the G7 and other things like that, where all of a sudden they had their masks off, and as you said, it's not a guarantee against catching it. So, if it's good enough for them to have masks and to have all football matches and have people coming in here left, right and centre through air travel, that to me doesn't equate to being what's being told. That's all I'm saying.
Tony. A few months ago, last year, and this year, when the second wave come along, there was 1,000, 1,500, 800, 900 dying every single day with that. So you start taking precautions. At first, they brought the lockdown in. That helps to stop it a little tiny bit. Then they say they brought the mask in. That helps a little bit more. And then they brought the injections in, which helps a little bit more. And each little bit you do helps to prevent the spread of the virus. But if everybody just gone wandering around outside without wearing masks and God knows what, and all that, hugging and dancing in the back of the car, like, you know, hugging and kissing, I should say, with Fred. Think what would have happened. There wouldn't have been 2,000 dying a bloody day. There'd have been 10,000.
Tell me this, Tony, come on now. How many people have died today, all right, through not having their treatment of all the different things that is out there that we used to be treating? How many people are dying of that and how many people are dying of COVID? Give me some statistics.
But we don't know the statistics.
There you go, then.
We don't know. It all has to come out in the end. They probably put a lot of people that down as COVID, that they've had some underlying illness that would have killed them in the next 2 or 3 months, but because they've got the COVID, they've finished them off a bit sooner with underlying health problems and things like that. There's all that to take into consideration. You know, but if you think about it, at least we've managed to slow the death rate down by a combination of all the things they brought in.
Tony, what, you still haven't answered. Why is it that all these football people from FIFA can come here and they're not going to accept this, that and the other, and it's all being allowed? Now surely, doesn't that click in your little brains, any of you lot?
Yeah, but before they can go to these places, they have to have a test to say they're not carrying it, you know, before they could even go, you know. So you've got that boat.